Santa, tell me if you're really there. Don't make me fall in love again if he won't be here next year. Santa, tell me if... Hey guys! So for today's video, I'm super, super, super excited about it. It is a winter DIYs video and like room DIYs. And this was actually my first video on YouTube that got just a couple months ago for fall DIYs. So I'm back with more DIYs and I am totally in love with my room. So if you guys want to keep on watching and see how to get these fun DIYs, then just keep on watching. That didn't even make sense. Whatever. Bye. For the first DIY, you're gonna need some regular computer paper, a paper towel roll, some tape, some scissors, and some fancy ribbon. We're first going to start off by measuring our pieces of paper. The bottom layer is going to be 6 by 6 inches, and it's going to be 10 pieces. The two middle layers are going to be 5 by 5 inches, and where you're going to need 20 pieces of paper. And the top layer is going to be 4 by 4 inches, and you are going to need 10 pieces of paper. And now we're just cutting them out. You're going to start by taking your 6 by 6 inch paper and putting a piece of tape on the right top corner. Now you're going to take it and roll it into a funnel-like shape with a point at the top. Now taking another piece of tape, put it on the folded part of the paper. Continue doing that with all the paper you have. Now we're taking our paper towel roll and putting our funnel shaped things, the 6 inch ones, and placing them on the bottom of the tree just to where the bottom of the cone touches the whatever surface you're working on. Once you're done with your first layer, you're going to take your 5 inch squares and start on the second. Now you're going to stick those 1 to 1.5 inches above the first layer. Just continue taping those all above the first layer. Now for the top and final layer, we are going to be taping the paper inside of the paper towel roll. And it is going to want to pop up, so you're going to have to tape it to the outside of the paper towel roll also. Once you're done, it should look like this. So since the bottom layer is getting flattened by the rest of the layers, we're going to flip it over and just stuff some tissue paper in there just to make it a little bit more fluffed. And now I just put a pretty bow on the top of mine. If you guys are wondering, I got this amazing idea from Ropes and Design, and I'll leave their link down below. So for these popsicle stick snowflakes, you're going to need some popsicle sticks, some glue, any paint of your choice, some paintbrushes, and some scissors, and any kind of newspaper just to lay down. So I started out by gluing together 2 popsicle sticks, and I made 3 sets of 2 popsicle sticks, and then I glued those together. Next, I'm putting a small dab of glue on the end of each popsicle stick and sticking a popsicle stick to 2 of them, making a hexagon. Now, where each popsicle stick meets, I'm putting a dab of glue and putting another popsicle stick.
also might need something to support this popsicle stick, as I did. And now I'm just painting all of my snowflakes white. So for this next project, you're going to need some ornaments, some tape, some thread, and some scissors. Now you're starting out by taking your thread and cutting it to any kind of length that you want. These are all random, so it doesn't matter the length. Then you're just going to be tying it into the ornament, like where the ornament would usually have a hook on it. But instead you're going to be tying that, and tie it as many times as you find necessary. Now you can just cut off the excess string. I recommend using hooks, but I'm just taking a piece of tape and putting it on the tip of the string and putting it on my ceiling like this. And here's the finished product. So for these coffee filter snowflakes, you're just going to need coffee filters, tape, and scissors. Start by laying it out flat, then fold it in half once, and fold it in half again, and fold it in half again, and fold it in half as many times as you want, but the more you fold it, the better the detail is. So now I'm just cutting out my design. I'm just gently unfolding the paper, and here's the final product. So now I'm just doing the same thing, but of course I'm going to be cutting a different pattern in this snowflake because no snowflake is exactly the same. I think this one is my favorite out of all of them. I really like the way this one turned out. So now I'm just taking some tape and taping them on my window.
Thank you guys so much for watching. And if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up down below and subscribe. It'll really mean a lot. Also, I'm almost up to 400 views on my outfit of the week's video, so that's really, really awesome, and thank you guys so much. Bye!